Mr. Rashid, my question is more for Mr. Ghoni. Mr. Ghoni, you are either you can either be a separatist or you can be a nationalist. If you support the man who attacked Parliament, Then you are supporting a separatist sentiment. Can the Chief Minister of Jammu and Kashmir support the separatist mindset?
Please, give me a minute. Mr. Rashid doesn't allow anybody to talk. You see, what I would like to say is, you see, your expression about the whole thing, Parnav, with due deference, I don't agree the way you try to nail the people. You know, this is totally not acceptable. What I am trying to tell you, you say that you take either this side or that side. You come and see how much sides when you reach to Kashmir, you take. You come and see how much sides the media takes.
Sir, you tell me on the issue, sir. Your party is trapped on the issue.
Kindly.
You're deflecting, sir.
Kindly, you're deflecting. See, if you are saying something, Parnab, let me be very, very specific about one thing. You see, it is not the point. If you look at, you are saying separatist. The Supreme Court judgment, which confirms the sentence of Afzal Guru, even does not accept him as a terrorist. Please kindly go and see the Supreme Court judgment.
1 minute, sir. You are doing everything but answering my question, sir. My question is simple, sir. Omar Abdullah's party is a member of the government in Delhi, sir. And Omar Abdullah, as a member of the ruling coalition in Delhi, can he support a man who plotted to attack the Indian parliament, sir? You can either be a separatist and support it, or you can be a nationalist and oppose it.
There are, Parnab, if I tell you, there are many big note of interrogation to be explained by the our democratic system. I'm sorry to say it, but I am trying to tell you from the facts of the case.
So what
I am not on the fact. You see, once you say
does your conscience tell you to support a man who attacked parliament? Can you have a conscience vote on it and say that I will not issue a party vote this way or that?
Where is the question of supporting the man? Question is not for nobody is saying, even Mr. Rashid is not saying that you upset the judgment of the Supreme Court. No. Supreme Court judgment is there. There is a power with the president, which power president has yet
to
exercise.
I want to know whether your party and Omar Abdullah through this whole tweet started this all. Now he's trying to avoid taking a position on it. That is a simple matter as far as I understand.
No. You see,
you want one foot in power in New Delhi and one foot in Srinagar.
What I know till this time, please listen to me. What I am saying at this time to you is that the party has yet to meet. Party president is out. He will be reaching here by 29. And these people have to have a meeting. And so, after having a meeting, they will make their stand
clear. So it's very convenient.
This is what Mr. Rashid is saying, that we should have made it clear by now.
Chief Minister who tweets in absentia. This is a bizarre situation. He tweets, but he will not take...
Parnam, I have not been able to understand up to this time that what is bad in that tweet.
Sir, my point is simply this. It's an indirect support.
It states a stand. It takes a stand
on a person who attacked our parliament and who is responsible for the killing of all the security men on the attack on parliament.
Tweet says that what Tamil Nadu Assembly has done. If J&K Assembly would have probably would have been different.
So it's not support.
It's not a support.
Then oppose it in the assembly.
That's what I'm telling you. It's not for me to.
Sir, such an important statement can't be Omar Abdullah's musings on Twitter. It's a little superficial to do things that way.
No, it's a serious issue. Twitter probably.
I think
you have, Parnab, put this Twitter in a different context. I even today stand by my word what I told in your previous discussion. I said it very clearly that look, This is a case where mercy petition is still pending and is yet to be decided.
So you, it's nobody happening in the assembly. It's happening. The resolution is happening judgment. In an assembly of which
nobody is asking for the
of a state where you are the chief
judgment.
Minister. No, no, one second. I'm getting different views.
Look, we have certain position.
I'm getting different views
because of that position.
Mr. Goni, Mr. Goni, let's get yes. other views. In. I'm going to Meenakshi Lekhi next. Meenakshi Lekhi. You know, it's a little bit more serious than that, isn't it? I mean, this is a politically, it's an explosive issue. I'm sure Omar Abdullah knows
you
that.
You see, two things. Of course, Omar Abdullah knows that. And as I said, both parties are having supple spines and are trying to only win brownie points and bending backwards in pleasing the people. And one thing I want to make clear, when we talk about state
as
of Jammu
if,
and Kashmir,
you,
every time, let me complete. Who are the people of Jammu and Kashmir? Who are the people of Jammu and Kashmir? People of Delhi do not
sense.
People of Jammu and Kashmir. There are people in Jammu, there are people in Ladakh who outnumber the people in the valley. And people of Delhi are trying to control even the view of people from Jammu and people from Delhi. So people of Delhi do not have the voice of people from Jammu and Ladakh. That is why misinformation which is being spread constantly needs to be corrected. Number two, Mr. Shabnam talked about presidential power.
Yes.
But presidential power needs to be exercised on what? One man who has not even filed his own mercy petition. The man is not saying that he is bound by the Constitution of India. The person is against the very democratic setup from where he wants to derive pleasure and get himself out. It cannot be permitted. The stance on terrorism has to be identical, be it the state of Jammu and Kashmir, be it from the state of Punjab, or be it from
one minute, one minute, yes. No, I want Shabnam Hashmi to respond. I want Shabnam Lone to respond. I want Shabnam Lone to respond. 1 minute, sir.
Terrorism needs to be cleared. Stance on terrorism needs to be cleared. Presidential power is to be exercised.
So what about the terrorism?
1 minute, Mr. Rashid.
Why are you not talking
Mr. Rashid.
Discrish, allow me to complete
please,
my sentence. You can't outshout me.
Let her complete.
Outshout me. Don't outshout me.
Mr. Rashid, let her complete. Let the lady complete, Mr. Rashid.
Then kindly give them a
discretion cannot be arbitrarily exercised.
Mr. Rashid, let him.
Discretion cannot be exercised by the president arbitrarily.
Mr. Rashid, let the lady complete.
Discretion is law-bound.
There are many of the
discretion has to be law-bound and under the constitutional mandate.
You see,
it has to be under the constitutional mandate.
Mr. Rashid, 1 minute.
Discretion cannot be arbitrary. If an arbitrary decision is taken.
Mr. Rashid, you have accepted on this show, Mr. Rashid, exactly 5 minutes back, you have accepted, Mr. Rashid, that this is a political issue. In the application of discretion, and I can be stand corrected, I'm not a lawyer like Shabnam Lone and in the exercise of discretion, I have a human heart, if you will define it like that, I don't have a problem. Yeah, human heart is fine, but
not making sense. You are not able to find one Abdul Guru from the state. One minute, I'm coming.
Ladies and gentlemen, let me come in now.
One minute, sir.
May I please?
We need police, 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 police
been hearts of Kashmiris and you have accommodated.
Mr. Rashid, Mr. Rashid,
I am in the heart of Kashmir, but appeasement is not the right process. Justice needs to meet
for liberty in Kashmir. They are doing anything. Mister, some are in uniform and some are in
the support
of the government. There are many Abdul Ghani.
Nobody is doing anything.
I am not defending Abdul Ghani.
I am coming in at this stage.
Whatsoever we want, we can do it.
Okay, now. I just want to say here.
Will you start talking about them? I want you to talk about the genocide of Kashmiri Pandit.
You don't call JLLT as a separatist.
Now, one second, Mr. Rashid. Meenakshi, will you please? Meenakshi, may I request you? May I request you, Mr. Rashid, may I request you, please, kindly, thank you, please, sir, may I please come in? I want to just say to you, and I take this question to Shabnam Lone because it was first addressed to her. I think she heard the first part. The question is this. Talk of a human heart and all is fine, but among the consideration of relevant factors in the exercise of pardon, Shabnam Lone, such as length of a sentence already undergone, the prisoner's behavior, and involvement in other crimes, you cannot bring extraneous and irrelevant grounds which are political. There are innumerable judgments which clearly say you cannot bring extraneous, irrelevant political factors because they will vitiate the entire legal exercise. We have the petitioner, the person moving the resolution in the Kashmir Assembly on the show tonight, Mr. Rashid, accepting it's political. This is pure politics over the man who attacked our parliament. Isn't it?
Well, let you not put words in my mouth, sir.
You said it just 5 minutes back.
At the end of the day, this is all the political problem. At the end of the day, it is political problem, but it doesn't mean that we should stop telling
truth. Shabnam Lone, I want Shabnam Lone to come in and also respond to the point Meenakshi made earlier. Yes.
Can I come in, Arvind?
Yes, but Shabnam, you're in.
Can I come in?
Yes, ma'am.
You see, for all these politicians who are bickering, you see, kya gazab hai is zamane mein ek bhi sahib-e surur nahi. The fact is, all of them have their own agendas. We know that. But my question is very basic. First of all, for Mr. Umar Abdullah, who tweeted it,
Shabnam Lone does not have her own agenda.
Is a great social communication.
At the end of the day. She has contested the election and she has lost.
Tweeting is... Arnab, can I please speak?
Go on, ma'am.
See, tweeting is a great social interaction and it's the best communicator these days. I myself on tweet. But for Umar Abdullah, the message is tweet, then don't delete. That's exactly what he did. There's no need for the chief minister. He tweets, he should tweet. There was no need for him to have a run to the Himalayan look as soon as somebody from the BJP or someone else said that he had done something that was wrong. It was only due to the efforts of Times Now. I think you had saved the page. That's how other people came to know that's what he had tweeted. But the question is, again, I think we are jumping the gun. What is the legal issue on this? Can Afzal Guru file a clemency petition under Article 72 before the President? The answer is absolutely yes. He has every right to do that. Now, can any political party, for that matter, catalog...
He has not filed it. No, 1 minute. He has not filed it. He has not filed it.
I said he has a right.
No, he has not filed it.
I said he has a right.
If he doesn't exercise the right, then what? If he doesn't exercise the right, then what?
Anybody on his behalf, no.
So are you saying the political parties on his behalf are... Then why don't you...
complete my argument, Arnab? It's very relevant, please.
Let her complete.
It's very relevant.
I'm letting her complete.
The question is, the United States under Section 2, any person that you have a presidential pardon, and the Commonwealth countries, you have advisory boards where you have presidential pardons. Now, our president... Can she grant reprieve to any person who is sentenced to death?
If he asks for it,
is the complete
if he asks for it, he is politicizing the matter.
Now please let me state the legal position. It is the prerogative and the discretion of the president to grant pardon.
If he applies,
why it is done so?
If he applies
on three factors, Arnab. One. Sometimes the courts are burdened and their hands are tied with the evidence that is put up before them. Sometimes the evidence is not proper. Sometimes there is lack of evidence. And that is why the power has been granted to the president to grant
then
this
he has
review.
To apply.
Now question is, can any political party catalogue it in accordance with their own political agenda. Let it come to the president.
This is subterfuge in the legal system.